Time is winding down to the midterm elections, and our political pundits, Roger Putnam and Tim Robey from Putnam Robey Williamson Communications, back with us to break it all down. Gentlemen, Hello. Thanks so much for being back with us today. All right, we're looking at the U.S. Senate race. We are talking about Johnson and Feingold, and we've got a lot of people coming in on both sides to support these two.
Well, that's what I hear, and I guess Roger can address who the Democrats are, but I think it's akin to the last dance on the Titanic, any appearance with Senator Feingold right now, because this ship is going down, Roger. And Johnson, there's a big debate again tonight. Johnson will more than hold his own. Polls, regardless of what the senator says, are not tightening, and this race is just about over.
Well, I knew he was going to say that because he's got the talking points tucked away in his little pocket there. But Senator Feingold loves the spotlight. He loved it last week when he mopped the floor with Johnson in the debate. He's going to love it again tonight. Johnson has made himself scarce. To Robey's point, the only thing I'm going to agree to with him on this evening is the fact that the polls are tightening, internal polls showing they're within the margin of error. And we've got some heavyweight Democrats coming to Milwaukee to help out Feingold in some key areas with women and minority voters. It should be an interesting week, and it is tightening up.
All right. We haven't talked much about the congressional races. There are nine in play here. Where are we going to see the tight races?
I think you're going to see the Green Bay area. Tim's been making a lot of noise about the Republican wave and how big it's going to be. It is having an impact. No question about it. The 8th district up near Green Bay, the 7th around Wausau, and the 3rd with Ron Kind should be safe, but it's in play.
Yeah, it should be safe. And we're hearing news that there's a lot of outside influence in the Ron Kind Kampanky race, and that could make a play. It looks like Republicans are polling quite significantly higher in the other two with Sean Duffy and Reed Ribble.
Which is the seat left by Obie.
Right. Yeah. So Green Bay, those three are really in play. I think everything else is pretty much going to go as expected, and incumbents are going to be just fine.
All right. State legislative races at risk. Control of the two houses currently controlled by the Dems.
Well, the Democrats, let's start with the Assembly. There are six targeted races, of which Democrats hold five. And so I think the Republicans feel pretty good that they can win. They need to win four of those races to gain control of the majority. One of the Democrat races that is targeted is Oregon with Brett Davis, who is no longer there. But the fact is, I think the Republicans feel very good about the Assembly.
Yeah, it's in all of this, it's important to note that most of those seats that are in play, there was just a slim margin where Democrats took them over and retained or won the majority there. So it's not going to take a whole heck of a lot to switch them back over to Republicans if there is this wave that everybody's talking about, right?
And as far as the state Senate is, the Democrats, there are four key races there. None of them are in our area right here, but they're in Racine, Wauwatosa, Chippewa Falls, and Eau Claire. And the Democrats are struggling in all those right now. And so I think the Senate, Republicans feel pretty good about the Senate, too.
All right.
Yeah, there's really just one in the Green Bay area, the Lissay seat, that Democrats really would hope to win, and that will be critical.
Yep.
All right. Guys, thank you very much. Tim Robey, Roger Putnam, appreciate you coming in. David George, back with Final Second Forecast.